why won't the co-parents and the bureaucrats and the special interest groups let us live our lives anymore? Why are they always trying to save us when we don't need saving? The nanny state continues to flourish, folks, but we here at The Rebel are striking back. Thus, welcome to our ongoing Dubious Achievement Awards, in which we'll dole out special recognition to those meddling malcontents who are responsible for the most outrageous acts of nanny state-ism. Now, before we get tucked into our November recipients, Mr. Music, please.
Hey, take me out to the ball game. Take me out with the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack.
Uh-oh, did one of those guys say peanuts? Peanuts? Is he nuts? He may as well be singing a song about hand grenades in our ever-so-nutty, nut-free society. And so it is that our first runner-up for Nanny State Ninny for the month of November is the city of Hamilton. You see, the Hammer is looking at banning peanuts in all city buildings, including Tim Hortons Field, the home of the Tiger Cats. And not just a peanut-free section, folks. We're talking about the entire stadium. City councilors voted unanimously in favor of looking into a ban after one Hamilton mom, Melissa Thompson, said her 9-year-old daughter Fiona can't go to football games due to her nut allergy. So even though one poll indicates 85% of the public is against such a ban, Hamilton might end up enacting it anyway. Now look, nobody wants any harm to come to Fiona or anyone else with a nut allergy, but trying to turn the world into some giant bubble-wrapped 100% nut-free zone is unrealistic, and it's potentially dangerous if a false sense of security is created. So how about teaching vulnerable children to take the necessary precautions to ensure they stay out of harm's way, as opposed to counting on everybody else to implement a 100% nut-free zone, which may not even be possible in the first place? But our winner for Nanny State Ninny for the month of November is Joe Cracchiolo, the principal of Our Lady of Lourdes Catholic School in Cincinnati, Ohio. And oh, is this a beauty, folks. You see, Principal Cracchiolo suspended a first grader for horsing around with a bow and arrow. Now, wait a minute. I hear you saying, Menzoid, are you crazy? A kid using a bow and arrow at school? That's serious stuff. That's right, Johnny Rambo. Better to die for something than live for nothing. But folks, the kid wasn't using that kind of bow and arrow, you know, the real McCoy kind, the kind you use for hunting. And guess what? The kid wasn't even using this kind of bow and arrow either.
The new Nerf bow and arrow is coming your way, and it means business.
The power is pumping and arrows in your hand. Now your heart is thumping, fire as quick as you can.
Nerf bow and arrow.
Okay, I get the sense you're feeling a little confused right now, folks, and rightfully so, for if that first grader wasn't using a real bow and arrow, and he wasn't using a toy bow and arrow, what kind of bow and arrow was the kid using to incur that 3-day suspension? Well, that's the thing, folks. There was no bow. There was no arrow. No projectile was ever shot because the kid was pretending to shoot a make-believe bow and arrow. The weapon was imaginary, and it occurred during playtime at recess. All he was doing was this. You know, it brings to mind an especially surreal episode of Get Smart, in which Maxwell Smart is training two agents in a disarming exercise. But because Max forgot to bring a real gun or a prop gun to class, agents Caruso and Lundy have to carry out the exercise using an imaginary gun, like so. Ooh, I'm sure Principal Cracchiolo would give that footage an X rating or maybe even ban that episode entirely. After all, the kids' parents, Matthew and Martha Mille, pleaded with Cracchiolo not to suspend their son over something he did in a make-believe game, but that principal is no pal. Cracchiolo said, quote, I have no tolerance for any real, pretend, or imitated violence. And he went on to emphasize that an out-of-school suspension is indeed required. Oh, what a wonderful co-parent. Suspending a six-year-old for pretending to shoot an invisible imaginary weapon? Congratulations, Principal Cracchiolo, for you are our Nanny State Ninny winner for the month of November. And oh, how I wish I could deliver the trophy to you, affixed to a rapidly moving arrow, perhaps even a real one. For TheRebel.Media, I'm David the Menzoid Menzies.